All right. I just spent the last 2 days doing my version of a Hypertune. And when I say my version, I didn't order any of the products from Deepsky Products. I just went about using the tools I had, doing the work myself, following a lot of guides I found online, and doing some work that way. So I got them out, put back together, and got the backlash worked out the way I like it. At least I think I do. I have to put it under the stars. But there's things that I think should have come out better, and so I'm coming to the community to see if I can get some advice. The clutches are unlocked on the telescope right now, so you can see that it is currently in a balanced state. Moves around in right ascension really, really smoothly. I like that. Gonna lock this up here for a second. However, or I'm sorry, declination moves really smoothly, and I like that. But right ascension seems to stick a little. It doesn't quite have the play that my declination axis does. So I understand that this is supposed to be really smooth, and it seems like it is in one direction, but not really the other. And this is interesting, is when I try to balance it on this side, I mean, you can't really tell from here, but it sticks a lot more when it's in this orientation versus this orientation over here. And I'm not sure why, and that doesn't seem right to me. Usually crossing over about here, I can actually start to feel some resistance kick in. I'm not sure that I like that. Not sure what that means. Also, I can move my weights, and it should be much more out of balance than this, from what I understand. The slightest movement of weight should really throw the balance off, and I'm not seeing that as well. However, on this side, the movement again feels a lot smoother than when the telescope's over on this side. And I, for the life of me, cannot figure that part out. Another thing is, and this may be correlated, the telescope mount seems to be quieter when slewing from one side to the other. I'll power it on and show you what I'm talking about. So one of the things I did after I got it fully assembled is I did some just ran the gears all the way around for a while by doing this, and I did 3 revolutions in each direction to make sure that the gears meshed fine. I didn't hear anything unusual, except it'll get quiet. And then it'll get loud again. So that was 1 full revolution, obviously, in declination, and you probably noticed that there are points in time when the telescope orientation is horizontal, the motors are relatively quiet. But when it goes closer to vertical, there's a little bit more chatter coming out of the gears, and I believe that that's related to some sort of stiction going on in the axes. I noticed it also in right ascension. Right about there, it's quiet. Right before it hits the stop, you'll notice it'll start quiet and then get louder. Okay, maybe not. Really quiet now. So, I don't think I did any harm with the telescope. I don't think I made any problems worse. I just don't know why I didn't make things better, I guess. And where the distinction's coming from, and is the sounds I'm hearing when the mount goes from its normal volume to a really quiet volume, is that related to some distinction I've got going on? So, I'm hoping that some of you people who have done the Hypertunes and have used the Deepsky product Hypertune kit, or have just taken their mount apart so many times they know it inside and out, can shed some light on, did I not do enough polish on the brass rings? Do I maybe have a gear meshing issue? Should I maybe go back through and pack even more grease into some of my bearings? I'm at a loss right here, and I'd really hate to have my mount torn apart for 3 months while I go through and tinker with everything. So I'm looking for some sage wisdom here from those of you who have done this before and might be able to point me in the right direction. So thanks for taking the time to watch the video. I'm sorry it turned out to be so long, but I felt that it was important to show you everything that I've got going on. Thanks again for watching, and I hope to get some really good advice from people out there who know what they're talking about.